Welcome to the session of Introduction to the LTSpice software. Learning outcome of this session. In this session, we are going to see the use of the LTSpice software. We are going to see the adding of the component, creating the schematic, simulating and observing the output in the LTSpice software. This LTSpice software is basically based on the SPICE simulation or the SPICE tool. The SPICE is nothing but a simulation program with an integrated circuit emphasis. LTSpice is a high performance SPICE simulator software which will provide you the schematic capture, waveform viewer, and it will provide the models for simulation of analog circuit. The software is freeware. So how you can get the LTSpice software? Go to the website www.linear.com/LTSpice. So left click on download for Windows 7, 8 and 10. Download the LTSpice software and install it in your system. Register for the My Linear account in order to receive the update. So before proceeding, let me ask you one question. What are the other softwares available for the simulation of electronic circuits? You can pause the video, think about the question. You can search on the web for the softwares which are available for the simulation. You can write down your answer in your notebook. Return to the session to see the answer. Let me give you the answer. There are different softwares available such as Orcad Capture, TINA, that is developed by the Texas Instrument, Plex, Electric VLSI Design System and Logisim. Let us see the simulation of half-wave rectifier in LTSpice software. So what is a half-wave rectifier? Basically, half-wave rectifier consists of the diode. You know that the diode conducts only when its anode is connected to the positive terminal and its cathode is connected to the negative terminal. When you connect the anode to the positive and cathode to the negative, it will act as a closed switch, and thus whatever the input present at the diode will appear at the output. So from the figure you can see that during the positive half section or during the positive half cycle of the input, the diode will receive the positive at the anode and negative at the cathode. Because of that, this positive waveform half section will be available at the output. Whereas during the negative half cycle, the diode's anode will receive the negative and diode's cathode will receive the positive. Now, because of that, it will act as an open circuit and the output of the diode will have a zero output. So we have to see the effect by simulation of the half-wave rectifier in the LTSpice software. So this is the LTSpice software environment. Here you can select the create, from this option you can create the new file or new symbol. You can save the file. From this view, we can view the toolbar or disable the view of the toolbar. And from tools, you can select the control panel, color preferences, etc. From file, go to the file and create a new schematic. So here is an environment where you can draw the schematic. There are different options are available here. So this is the option for adding the component. This is the option for adding the diode. This is the option for adding the inductor. Similarly, this is the option for adding the capacitor. This is for adding the resistor. And this is for labeling a net. And this is the symbol for ground. And this is the symbol for wires. So this option is for the copy of the component. From this option, you can delete the component. This is the option for zoom in. And this is the option for simulation. This option will provide you the control panel. Here is an option which is used for the adding the commands. Now, for the half-wave rectifier, the basic component that we need is the diode. So go to the component, click diode. So here is an option of diode. So this is the directory where you can get the different components. So from that, I am going to select the diode. Click on OK. In order to rotate the component, you can use Control R. So in this way you can rotate the component. So let us add the component here. In order to deselect the component, you can press Escape. Now let us add the input supply, input source. Let us add the input source. Here type voltage. So here you can see the symbol of the supply voltage and click OK. add the supply here. Now deselect the component, press escape. Next, output resistor. So here is an option of the resistor, click on that option and add the resistor. Now let us add the wires. So there is an option of wire, click on that option, click on the positive terminal. From here connect this terminal to here, and from here connect this terminal to here. From here I will connect this terminal to here. In order to deselect the wire, just press escape. Now in order to give the supply, so I am going to provide the sinusoidal input. So if you move your cursor over the component, there is one option will appear. So when you see this option, just right click your mouse. Now here you can see the different parameters. So in this I am going to go to the advanced. So when you go to the advanced, there are different options are available. So go to the sine. So DC offset voltage, I will give the value 0. Amplitude, let us give the 5 volt. And frequency, let us give the 50 hertz. If you don't give the any value after the 50, it will automatically take it as a hertz. If you want to give the value in mega, you have to type a capital M. If you want to give the value in milli, then you have to type milli, small m. It means that it will take it as a milli hertz. If you want to give the gigahertz, then just G. So 50 means that it will take it as a 50 hertz, and click on OK. So here you can see the sine input is sinusoidal from 0, with the offset voltage of 0, amplitude of 5 and frequency of 50 hertz. Now let us select the diode. Go to the option, you will select, go to the diode symbol, move your cursor over this diode symbol, you will see the one option there, right click your mouse and select pick a new diode, and from that select 1N4148 and click on OK. In order to give the value of the resistance, just right click over that and give the value of the resistance, say 1. If you want to give the value in kilo ohm, just write K. If you want to give the value in mega ohm, write capital M. Now I am going to write the value K, stands for kilo ohm, and click OK. After that I am going to connect the ground, so click on that and here ground. So here is a complete schematic of the half wave rectifier. Now in order to simulate this, we have to go to the simulate option, and there is an option of edit simulation command. So this command will provide you different options such as AC analysis, DC sweep analysis, noise margin, a DC transfer output to the input, and a DC operation point calculation. So in this I am going to select the transient response, and the stop time will be 50 milliseconds. So the waveform will simulate it for this 50 milliseconds, and after that the output will be appears. So you can see the symbol. When you move your cursor here, you can see the option of run. So press that option, run. Now you can see the, here is the output window, and here is the your schematic. Now if you want to observe the output voltage, then just move your cursor over that terminal where you want to observe the output. You can see the symbol of the voltage marker. So this is a red indicate that the pencil indicate that the voltage marker. If you want to observe the current flowing through the resistor, then if you move your cursor over that resistor, you can observe the, there is a one ammeter present that indicate the flow of the current. The red arrow indicate the direction of the current. Similarly, if you move your cursor over the voltage input of the diode, then you will see the voltage marker. If you move your cursor over the diode, you will see the current marker. In case of the input source, you can see the direction of the current. So let us see the input voltage. So this is the input voltage. As you can see, this is a sinusoidal waveform. So this is the voltage axis. If you want to zoom over the waveform, you can select this area and zoom that. In order to zoom out, you can select this zoom out. And if you right click over that waveform, there is an option of zoom to fit. So just click that and it will reset your waveform, or the waveform will fit to your area. Now, in order to delete this particular waveform, just to go to the cut, and this waveform has to be deleted, then click here. So the waveform will deleted. In order to observe the output, just press here. This is the output, and for the input, this is the input. The green waveform represents the output and the blue waveform represents the input. In this way, we have simulated the half-wave rectifier in LTSpice software. And what we have seen here, we have seen how to add the component, how to connect those components with the wire, how to give the values to those components, and how to set the simulation parameters in the LTSpice software. These are the references used for the session. Thank you.